previously.
What's this other town?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
Broken right now.
And now we're back at her.
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. It could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have let them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity? They would have died out there.
We're not dangerous. Just regular folks.
What's dangerous is a bunch of people running outside and drawing their attention to us.
Lee's right. We're just regular folks, but we actually like helping people.
You'll have to excuse her. The hell he or anyone will. This is about survival. Do you guys not see what's happening?
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
I bet you would. You're a dumb, careless kid.
Then just go!
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
She's the leader here. But it looks like she's losing control of her people.
If you were in my shoes, you'd be the...
Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
Shit.
We let one in, you stupid shits!
We have to end this now.
Over my dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No! I'm cleaning him up! There's no bite! He's fine!
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen! We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten!
Shut up! We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in!
Kenny! Stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
It's either him or your son. I say it's him.
Goddamn right. Out on his ass with those things.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten! Lee, stop this! It's upsetting him!
Oh, I'm upsetting him! Upsetting is getting eaten alive!
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
Do you? You're not fucking acting like it.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened. She's not some snot-nosed toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
Fuck you and her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there!
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch!
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl. She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three.
Then we deal with it then. But right now, we're just freaking everybody out.
Then get ready to deal with it, because that boy is bitten.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now!
No! You don't touch that boy! You don't touch anybody! I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on! You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
Jesus!
Come on!
Man,
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in!
Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
What's wrong with him?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills? Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
There's probably another entrance. Maybe through the office.
How do you know that's an office?
Educated guess.
It doesn't matter. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
Damn, that'd be great.
Well, it's gotta get done. Plus, I'm quick, and I know Macon.
Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
So. A lot of shit just went down. We gotta help this asshole over here find some pills, because apparently he's got a heart condition. Alright. I'm just gonna go around and see if I can get some stuff here. If I remember correctly, yeah, there's these little granola bars over around that I can give them people. Do that, and I'll go around and get to know people. I haven't played this in a long time, so I have to really get to know people again here.
How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again, and I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UGA. Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead.
That sucks.
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this.
I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good.
Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
Yep, not just any little girl can do that, but a future protagonist.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They, own this place. They, pulled some bodies out of the office before we got here. They're gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Kat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead. Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
Hey, he looks like he's seen some shit.
Sure.
Goddamn.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves.
We killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happen. We didn't make a choice that killed Sean. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go.
That's pretty true. That's the thing that usually tears people up inside about situations like that. Is when they're looking back on it and they think that there's something they could have done.
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest.
Here.
It's not much, but here. For the boy.
Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Because honestly, that kid looks like he could use a freaking candy bar right now. I mean, Jesus. Yeah, he's got that, I've seen some shit look on his face. Huh?
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
Ugh.
You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but, you know.
Yeah. That guy saved you?
Yeah. Can you believe it? Those creeps or ghouls or whatever the hell they are. They were pulling our van apart and that guy, Doug, just came to the rescue.
You can never tell who the heroic ones are gonna be, I suppose.
He's kinda cute. In that parents' basement sort of way.
Huh?
Huh? Oh, nothing.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
Icon. Isn't that like an actual electronics company? Let's see. Volume's not working.
Nothing. There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
You're a news reporter. You don't know about batteries and electronics? You must have sucked at your job pretty bad.
It's not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. Hey there.
Hi.
Can I, get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
Still, huh?
Yeah, it wasn't much.
I know, Clem. I'll see if I can find something else for you. Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job.
We should get to know each other. If that's true, we're gonna be, like, survive with this girl.
So,
are you okay?
What? I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Wow, at least.
Yep.
This is awkward as a three-legged horse.
Okay.
That was as awkward as a three-legged horse. I'm not even joking with that.
It's not much, but here.
You sure?
Yeah. You're under quite a bit of stress.
Thanks. That's, really sweet.
Don't mention it.
She seems a little cold, but...
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
Alright, we got the batteries. Let's go take these to Carly.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
So, how's that radio coming?
Hey, Carly.
That radio working yet?
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Okay. Maybe... Let's go over the usual.
Nothing.
I don't think the volume is the problem. Yeah, get a better signal. And let's see here. Wait. She had them in backwards. This woman is technologically retarded.
As the unknown affliction continues to spread unchecked, the estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... My producer's telling me we have to get off the air.
Steve.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily.
God bless you all.
Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Oh, huh.
Sure, so, let's have a look.
Let's go have a look around.
Cool, and we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring him back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed.
Smart man.
Eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah.
Most likely.
I think so too. We better keep it down out of here. Too bad we don't have a way to come out here and watch the news.
Would be nice to know what's going on elsewhere.
Atlanta's in rough shape, and that's all I know. Look at the one trapped over there.
Better him than us.
Oh shit.
Oh shit.
Right there.
Do you know that guy?
He could be a drugstore employee.
So you're saying he might have the pharmacy keys?
I'm saying he might have the pharmacy keys.
I don't know. Could be anybody, you know? They start rotting and get all chewed up and...
Shut up, Doug.
B. Everett. So I'm guessing
look
that's...
Look at the uniform, though.
I guess that's his brother.
He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
That would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find.
Alright,
let's head back inside.
Okay.
Let's look in the office. Oh, this place looks nice.
I can't think about them in here.
We can't have a shitty situation.
This door leads to the back alley.
You go home just to figure out that apparently your family's gone.
Luckily, there's nothing I need in here. My parents came in here hoping to survive. But it looks like one of them was hurt. I wonder if it was my dad. Trying to be a hero, maybe. Or a protector, at least.
Find anything?
Why is it every time I play a freaking episodic video game, somebody has to tear a photograph?
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
Okay. So she knows what's up with Lee. Let's move this pallet.
What's that?
This was my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that.
Hmm.
Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Yeah, sure. More the merrier.
Sure.
Besides, you look enthusiastic.
Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers. Things have been scary, huh?
Yeah. It's not good. I don't know why everyone is crazy.
Neither do I, Clementine.
The world's crazy.
Nobody does.
The way it is.
I bet my dad does.
Okay, here we go.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
You didn't answer my question.
All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
Kids and their questions, man. Don't want to turn off.
I wouldn't blame them.
Why? Did you fight? I fight with my mom sometimes.
We didn't fight. We just didn't talk for a while. Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I got into some trouble, and I didn't talk to them for a while. This used to be their store. But let's just keep that between you and me, okay?
Okay. Because of the trouble?
Yeah, that's right. Now, let's get this done.
That's all she really needs to know. My opinion.
Ow!
Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
Swear to God, you reminded me of my sister.
I'll find you a bandage. It's the remote to my dad's TV. Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
Wait, it wasn't bleeding from the nail. Why put the bandage there? Like, down near the knuckle.
Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll track us down.
Yeah, come
Don't
on.
Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, stay close to Lee. He'll help you out.
Dad told me he bought that TV to watch baseball in the air, but I caught him watching his stories more than a few times.
You like the soaps, huh?
That's what I figured.
Let's go see about the pharmacy here.
The keys are on that zombie out on the street.
Let's get out of here, then.
Want to head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No, he wasn't.
Let's be honest with her.
Oh. Was he bad?
He was.
I kind of want to be honest with the kids. Let her know what's going on here. Now, I'm guessing I gotta take this picture. If I remember correctly, I have to take this picture to Doug.
How are we doing?
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power is still on.
You can just do that?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Holy jeez, you must have a hell of a memory.
Well fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't?
Zombies love TV, man.
That got a few of them to take notice.
Well, there's nothing on, so it's not gonna keep their attention from
that. Not enough.
Alright,
That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
I found this in the office. That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we could make.
Yeah, I agree. Just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kind of in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie or whatever?
Okay.
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do.
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a job.
Hey everybody, hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, sure leave a like. Share the video. If you haven't yet, subscribe. Until next time, this is Tora, the Undead Chronicler. See you next time.